I guess let's start with the session. Good evening, everyone. On the behalf of Team Dentist Channel Online, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. Today, we are having a live webinar on the topic Holistic Dentistry, which will be providing our homeopathic remedies to our common dental problems by Dr. Dennis Rodrigues. And before starting the session, I would like to make a few housekeeping notes. Those who have joined us from Facebook and YouTube Live, they can ask questions by commenting, and those questions will be answered once the session is over. Those who have joined here, they can ask questions by dropping your questions into question and answer box in your control panel, and they'll be taken up one by one at the end of the session. And number three, those who have not subscribed us to our Prime membership, I request them to do it ASAP. You'll be getting e-certificates for every session that you attend. So without further ado, I would just like to introduce our speaker to us. Dr. Dennis is a dedicated homeopath, pediatric nutritionist and a guidance counselor, having graduated with a BHMS degree from Goa University as a gold medalist. She went on to acquire training in Mumbai before beginning with her own venture, Evolve Homeopathic Clinic at South Goa. Believing that every individual has their own innate, unique capacity to heal and evolve into the best version of themselves, Dr. Dennis combines her knowledge of homeopathy, mind-body healing, psychology and nutrition as she facilitates the successful healing of her clients holistically. She firmly believes that a peaceful heart leads to a healthy body. Being aware of oneself and treating your illness as your friend is the philosophy she works on. So I welcome you, Doctor.
Thank you, Dr. Aditi, for the lovely introduction. I hope I'm audible and it's clear.
Yes, absolutely, ma'am.
Okay, that's good. So I will start screen sharing, and before we go ahead, a lot of you all may be intrigued by the topic homeopathy for dentistry. How will the little white pills really help, and what is this holistic dentistry all about? So whatever questions you all have while I'm presenting, I would like you all to put your questions definitely, as Dr. Aditi said, in the Q&A box so that we can answer them. But I really hope with this presentation it will be clear as to what I'm going to be speaking about and what is holistic dentistry all about. So the very first thing is we need to understand what is health. And as medical practitioners, we all know that when a person is healthy, they're usually in a balanced state of being. And how is that balance achieved? When there is a balance in your mind, body and spirit. And even true for dentistry, isn't it? A person will not be at their best of health if they have frequent caries or frequent episodes of toothache or even gingivitis for that matter. And I'm talking about recurrence over here, because the entire topic is going to be focusing on that. How do we prevent this recurrence from happening in a more holistic manner? So yes, a healthy person is in balance in mind, body and spirit. Now, what is homeopathy? Just to help you all understand what exactly is homeopathy for all those who might be knowing that, okay, it's the small tiny pills, but what is the system it works upon? So it is one of the allied branches of medical science that has shown several miracles in treating various rare cases. And you will get all of these cases in PubMed journals as well. It was codified into medical science in 1789 by Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, a German physician. The basic law of homeopathy is the law of similars. That is, it works on the principle of similia similibus curantur, like cures like. That means a homeopathic remedy can cure an illness if it produces similar symptoms in a healthy person. And all of these remedies, what are used, are derived from vegetable or mineral sources or animal sources even. So the use of homeopathy in dentistry is a little bit of a thoughtful innovation that opens up several new clinical opportunities, because we are very tuned. A lot of you all may be very tuned to understanding that, okay, if it's a toothache or let's give a painkiller, or if it's a post-dental procedure, let's prescribe enzoflam most commonly, right? How can you introduce homeopathy to your patients who may be allergic to painkillers, to some forms of diclofenac, or even those who are having repeated problems with no idea of how they're going to get completely healed from this recurrent caries or gingivitis for that matter? So systemic diseases are first observed in the oral cavity, right? Staining of teeth, bad odor. Systemic diseases, like a bad odor can always mean it could be a chronic gastritis issue even. So the dentist who has sufficient knowledge of homeopathy, alternative medicine, and the holistic aspect of treating a patient can prescribe an appropriate homeopathic medicine, thereby benefiting the patient on a whole. And that is what I am going to be speaking about today. Now, how is homeopathic remedy prescribed? If you all can see over here, you all will see this slide with this word individualization. So although I'm going to be speaking about common remedies, which are most commonly used, actually homeopathy, the base of homeopathy works on this principle. So if you see over here, there are three fingerprints, right? Different colors, green, pink, and blue. What does it mean? Every individual is unique. Every individual has their own way of reacting to a particular situation, has their own likes and dislikes, has their own way in how they conduct themselves. And what a homeopath actually does is study this nature, this consistent nature of an individual across various situations, stress, tension, interest, hobbies, dreams, and fears, to find out that one particular characteristic of that person on which we prescribe a remedy. So even though we are going to be learning specific remedies in a few minutes, what individualization means, that of course, y'all can, I could share this PowerPoint presentation to Dr. Aditi, y'all would have access to probably some of the remedies which are commonly used, but it is always better that to prevent a person from getting recurrent gingivitis or recurrent caries or recurrent mouth ulcers or bad odor, it is very apt to go the route of individualization, where you actually study the person in its entirety. I hope I'm clear until here, or am I going too fast, or is it fine?
It's absolutely good, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. So the scope of homeopathy in dental practice is broad. Different ailments people commonly experience are what? There is pain, discomfort, inflammation, bleeding, all of which, the basics, can be easily handled with homeopathy. Most of our people who might not prefer painkillers, who want to stay away from painkillers, who want to they are already coming from as backgrounds where they prefer an alternative treatment, then definitely these are the most common conditions when there's pain, discomfort, inflammation, and bleeding. It can be easily handled with homeopathy. Homeopathy has a role in calming dental anxieties, speeding recovery, etc. I'll just interject here and I just interject at this moment and speak to you about a case about a patient who had a lot of issues. She would be morbidly afraid of going to the dentist, really afraid. And she would always say that I'm so scared, you know, to even open my mouth and sit in that dentist chair. So rather than prescribing or putting her on an anti-anxiety pill, she can take a role of, she can take actually a specific remedy, a homeopathic remedy, which will help to calm her and she can safely undergo the procedure. So in that patient, since we knew the history of the patient, we had prescribed to her a remedy, Calcarea carbonica. I don't think I've covered this particular remedy in my slides here, but that was her individualized remedy. You remember I just spoke about individualization in the previous slide? Yeah, we just spoke about treating the patient by understanding the patient completely. So when she took her remedy, she did not really feel all that anxious and the procedure went on smoothly. So yes, homeopathy has a role in calming dental anxieties when a person has fear to go to the dentist, speedy recovery, post-surgical procedures, etc. And even we can even hope to improve the overall health of the patient and not just the dental condition presented to us. So it might not just be a bad odor, or it might not just be frequent caries or abscesses, but we are also taking care to prevent this recurrence from happening. Homeopathic prescribing in dentistry may be either acute, like specifics, or constitutional, or a combination of these. So what is this acute? Acute prescribing is a treatment specifically for the disease or ailment. Toothache, then yes, we have a particular remedy for it. Constitutional prescribing takes place on the principles of individualization. That is, after studying the patient in on a whole. So that involves analyzing a person's temperament, their reaction, the disposition, as well as behavioral tendencies. It is possible to prescribe one medicine to suit the temperament or the psychological state and something for the physical problem. I will discuss a case later on during the session. So what is holistic dentistry? Actually, what is this holistic dentistry? Holistic dentistry takes into account a person's entire state of physical and emotional health. And holistic dentist, and this is a big thing in UK, Australia, and NZ. And specifically, since I visited NZ a couple of years ago, they are big into using natural modalities. Yes, doctor, I will tell you the name of the remedy later on when I discuss the cases. So holistic dentists use natural therapies, often in combination with conventional ones, to prevent, diagnose, and treat diseases of the oral cavity. There is a large percentage of our population who desires an approach to dentistry that is gentle and more preventive, because you don't want the patient coming again and again with the same issue. No doubt, okay, you would enjoy working or doing a particular procedure, but at the same time, the patient may not feel all the more comfortable about having to do frequent fillings or having to, take frequent OPGs to check out on their dental health. So some people prefer more medication which is preventive rather than the standard conventional methods. And these patients are interested in dentistry that focuses on healing the mouth as well as the rest of the body without the use of toxic restorative materials and chemicals. And if you look this up on the internet, you will get heaps of resources and scientific papers published on this, and practitioners in the West actually following holistic dentistry. And what does it mean? Opting for metal-free, mercury-free, BPA-free, and fluoride-free procedures with a greater emphasis on caring for the whole mouth, not just that one tooth filling, but on actually caring for the whole mouth to prevent the recurrence of caries in the other teeth, controlling infections in a manner that will not necessarily harm the rest of the body. Holistic dentistry is also referred to as alternative dentistry. It considers the impact on the rest of the body when dental treatment is performed on the jaws, teeth, and gums. So yes, a person might develop fever or might develop, like I said, anxiety. And normally we do have a list of specific remedies to be given, but it is always better when it is given after studying the temperament of the patient, which is why I began by speaking about individualization. Yeah. So what about homeopathy in dentistry? There are many conditions in dentistry where homeopathic medicine is used. And Calcarea Carb is just one of the remedies over here, which I've mentioned, which I spoke about. One of the doctor, Pragya, was asking what is the name that I had given to the patient who had anxiety. She was given Calcarea Carb. And if you see over here, Calcarea Carbonica is a specific remedy for a delayed tooth eruption in children. Okay. But now she was an adult of 57 years old. I gave her the remedy just because that was her state. When I mean her state, she expressed the fears and her temperament was that of a person who fit this remedy. It's just a tip of the iceberg of a concept that I'm introducing to you all today. So homeopathic medicine like Natremure is used for cold sores and fever blisters, lips and corners of the mouth for dry and cracked lips. Calcarea carbonica is a remedy used for delayed eruption. Antimonium crude is a remedy used for toothache, which is really worse at night and is aggravated by heat. So suppose a person experiences toothache that happens mostly at night and just gets worse if drinking hot coffee or hot tea, then antimonium crudum in a lower potency works very well for such cases. TMJ disorders, neuralgia, hemorrhage, gingivitis, and periodontitis. Arsenic album is used for unhealthy bleeding gums as well as alveolitis. It is also an excellent remedy used to calm the mind in cases of anxiety. And I bet a lot of you all must have heard about arsenic album during the first wave of COVID-19 last year, where it was given as a preventive for COVID. Not, I wouldn't say like it would prevent a person from getting COVID, but again, it calmed down the fears of a person and it really helped build up the immunity. I've done a study even on this. So this is a remedy used for unhealthy bleeding gums, also when there are a lot of fears as well. Belladonna is best used for early dental abscesses accompanied by redness and throbbing. So when the dental abscess just begins to form, when there is redness and throbbing, belladonna is the remedy which is used. What is aconite? Aconite is another remedy used to calm the mind. Apprehension, panic, fright, general mental and physical restlessness, or sudden violent attacks. Belladonna, again, apart from what we discussed before, it is also used for bruxism, which causes painful teeth. And no matter what combination of symptoms or chief complaints the individual is suffering at any given time, they are all manifestation of a single disease that is unique to that individual. That is why, like how a thumbprint is unique or a fingerprint is unique, every individual person is unique, which is why we are introducing today the concept of holistic dentistry. And definitely homeopathy is not a substitute for good dietary practice, oral hygiene habits. And dental treatment can never be completely natural. I do agree on this. And we all here agree on this, coming together on this platform. But utilizing homeopathic principles can avoid some of the side effects and also make it more pleasant for the patients. Imagine having some kids come to your clinic and tell them that you're going to give some sweet sugar pills for calming down the pain which happens post a dental procedure. How happy would they be that they get to eat something like chocolate, right? I'm sure every kid would enjoy that. There are a lot of list of common remedies that I have prepared and we've put together. So one is Arnica Montana. It's the most commonly used remedy, at least if patients come to me before going for any dental procedures. Okay. It's a first aid remedy for any situation involving bruising and tissue damage. Patients take it both before and after stressful dental work. And I have an amazing case to share where Arnica was used and the patient did not experience pain post a tooth extraction, including dental surgery. Arnica may be used as long as soreness lasts or followed by another remedy aimed at more specific symptoms. Very good for patients in case they are allergic again to painkillers or do not prefer taking medications like enzoflam. This remedy can help. Calendula can help overcome inflammation, infection, and abscesses. It can be taken internally or it can be used as a herbal tincture. It is applied to injured gums and areas around the teeth. The tincture can help reduce the chance of infection and help the tissues heal after being cut or bruised. Chamomilla is helpful when a person is very sensitive following dental work. It sometimes works when pain medication have little or no effect. This is another remedy which I commonly use to for all my patients who are abroad. And normally they prefer taking with them around 20 to 30 essential remedies, like an essential remedy kit when they go. So anytime they come up with to take you to whatsoever issues, chamomile is a one remedy I rely upon, which brings them instant relief until they get an appointment with the dentist over there. So it also helps the nerve response become more balanced. And we've all heard of chamomile tea, right? It is used to kind of calm the mind. So yes, chamomilla also helps to ease pain of toothache. Gelsemium is a remedy can help ease the apprehension and anxiety that often precedes a visit to the dentist. The person may tremble and feel weak and mostly present with dizziness and develop a headache, or mentally feel very dull and lethargic. And that is when gelsemium could be indicated in anxiety before dental procedures. Hypericum is another excellent remedy used for its soothing effect when nerve areas are injured. Shooting, jabbing pains often felt, hypericum is very useful after oral surgery. Again, we have come to toothache. These are some very commonly used remedies, and one of the most common over here what we see is plantago. So toothache can be one of the most distracting pains imaginable, right? We feel like we should get an appointment with our dentist immediately. And it is so agonizing to wait for that appointment, isn't it? So alongside this, there are a number of homeopathic remedies that can be helpful. You have Belladonna, Pulsatilla, Coffea, Staphysagria, Plantago, and Sepia. One thing which you all can actually do in your clinics to all the dentists attending is always keep Plantago mother tincture with you all. If a patient does not want to take any enzoflam or any painkiller, you could also advise your patients to keep it, because this can be a cotton piece can be soaked with Plantago mother tincture, and it can be just kept in the area of pain and it brings about instantaneous relief. So we have other specific remedies which need to be given as per the patient's presentation and in a particular potency. So you have Belladonna for throbbing pain, Pulsatilla where heat brings on the pain. We also learned another remedy before, Anthem Crude. Coffea, wherein if the person has cold water, cold drinks, it becomes better. And that is when coffee is a remedy that is indicated. Staphysagria, when there is frequent decay, clenching of teeth. Plantago, where there are sensitive teeth, sore to touch, exposed roots, worse with cold air or fluids. And Sepia is another really good remedy for toothache in pregnancy. So am I clear until now? A very new concept for all the dentists over here. Lots of information, lots of remedies. But I hope I'm kind of making some sense when it comes to introducing the concept of holistic dentistry and what role does homeopathy have to play. Is it going all right? If you could just give a thumbs up or something.
Yes, ma'am, you can proceed. It's going great.
Yes. And the common dental condition... Other common medicines for toothache, we have aconite, arnica, magnesium phosphate, silica, chamomilla, and plantago. Locally applied every 15 minutes, excellent therapy for sensitivity, giving immediate and long-lasting relief after a few applications. And it is also termed as a toothache tincture because it's so specific. All right? Go to the next. Very good. Abscesses. So abscesses where we have toothache with a gum boil, which is Belladonna is given for toothache with a gum boil, which is red, swollen and throbbing, and best used for abscesses early on. The 30th potency every half hour really relieves this gum boil which is there. Myristica is another remedy which has an abscess which runs down into the neck. And it can also resolve the problem in cases where surgical incision seems essential, especially in aged patients who are not very comfortable at certain point actually go in for a surgery because of their age. Then these are the remedies which can help. Silica is useful if the abscesses have been for a long time and it really hasn't come to a point where it's going to discharge. It looks like there's going to be discharge, but then it just doesn't. Heparsulf, if there is a chronic recurring abscess, then the sixth potency of Heparsulf works really, really well. Merxol is used for bad breath as a result of sores with a lot of salivation. So when a patient presents with excessive salivation and bad breath, this is a remedy used. Another remedy is pyrogenum, which is used when there is pus, but without it being drained. Bryonia is another remedy indicated when there's acute inflammation or if the pricking pain is relieved after applying pressure. Pulsatilla too can help with toothache where the pain is accentuated by heat and relieved by cold water. Gum disease, gingivitis, as you all can see over here, it is very painful, major cause of tooth loss, and infected or bleeding gums are usually caused, all of you here know, by a buildup of plaque on the teeth because of poor dental hygiene, because of excess of carbs or sweet, or because the saliva is too acidic. In less common cases, vitamin deficiency, blood disorders, or drugs may be the cause. And what are the remedies? We have Arsenicum album, Serum Fors, Merxol, Nux vomica, Phosphorus, Hypericum, and China. Like I said, all of these remedies are indicated, but when a patient is studied and in depth, when a patient is understood in depth, like let me give you an example of a very famous remedy of Phosphorus, okay? It's a very good remedy given for bleeding conditions, okay? And if any of my students ask, okay, what can we give for bleeding? Phosphorus would probably be one of the first answers. But what are we looking out for before prescribing phosphorus? Yes, we see over here that there is swollen gums that bleed easily with an overproduction of saliva. But a very, very characteristic of the remedy phosphorus is that these people love to eat ice. They love to eat ice, they love cold, they love cold drinks. They are very afraid of thunderstorms, rains. So, you know, these are the characteristics we pick on before prescribing. Because if you see here, all these remedies have bleeding gums. But what is that one characteristic? Like in Arsenicum album, there will be a lot of fear and a lot of anxiety. In Merxol, there will be bad breath along with the bleeding. In Nux vomica, also it's generally suited to a person who has sort of a high profile job, let's say like the managing director of a big time company and who's always stressed and comes up with these complaints and frequent gingivitis, then Nux vomica is the remedy. So you have to always understand, and there are heaps of issues online, or there is a particular set of books which maybe even for acute prescribing when a patient comes, or when you feel the need to kind of the patient prefers a more holistic approach, then it's always better to choose homeopathy as a holistic science for all of these issues. Broken teeth post extraction. So some people, a lot of people, in fact, in India more so, a lot of people don't really go for regular dental checkups. They'll go only when there is a major problem, either by when teeth break due to an accident or just falling out. Symptoms associated with potential loss of tooth or teeth can understandably include anxiety and shock. Like for people who are getting old, they might just, you know, it's a part of their body which they're losing at the end of the day. And what is the most commonly used remedy? We all, again, come to Arnica. It is effective in dentistry as it is in other fields of healthcare, mostly in orthopedics. It can be used in surgery, giving it to patients before and after treatment, as well as its affinity for the psychological state. It is brilliant for treating soreness, swelling, and bleeding, and hence making it an excellent choice for post-dental procedures. Hypericum, again, if alternated with Arnica, it is very useful given in third molar tooth extractions because there can be nerve damage associated. So Hypericum is a very good remedy when nerve damage is associated. phosphorus should be considered to again control bleeding. Like I said, it's one of the famous remedies for bleeding. And if there is a tooth extracted and later in the day, there is bleeding which happens. So in case a person is not responding to Botroclol, which is quite common, I believe, in the industry for curbing blood, for stopping blood loss, then phosphorus 30C can be prescribed and you will there will be instantaneous relief. I have a case to share based on this. Ruta is also another remedy indicated when the bone is injured in a dental procedure. Cemphitin is a medicine to think of as it encourages the growth of tissue following dental trauma. We come to something like mouth ulcers, which a person can come to you with bad breath and mouth ulcers, probably speaking about a deeper lying chronic issue like gastritis, and it could be quite irritating for them. There is something called as a homeopathic mouthwash, which we'll come to in the later slide, but there are some other homeopathic remedies which might help, and these are nitric acid ulcers with a raw appearance that bleed easily, borax, small red ulcers which come up worse when salty foods are eaten or pickles are eaten. If given every 15 minutes, it helps. Hydrastis when there is sticky saliva. So you see heaps of remedies, specific indication is what we are looking out for. We have propolis tincture, which is also beneficial, applied neatly or taken as a mouthwash to release symptoms while healing occurs. It seems to reduce the amount of time ulcers take to heal from 7 to 10 to 2 or 3 days. Coming to a very, very common thing which most of your dentists may have encountered in practice is medicines for dental anxiety, which I spoke about at the start as well. Anxiety associated with the visit to the dentist is not uncommon. Aconite, yes, there is a state of fear and anxiety present, mental and physical restlessness, but fright is the predominant feature. And it is given when there is acute fright, like, okay, you tell the person they are going to the dentist and that person will just be like, oh, I really don't want to go. I'm not comfortable going. I'm worried and I'm scared about what's going to happen. Gelsinium is indicated when the patient is feeling weak in the knees, fearful, lacking in energy, often presenting with a dizziness many a times, and they can be used the night before and or the day of the surgery for a relaxing, calming effect. I particularly find gelsinium very, very helpful to kind of, you know, calm the nerves. Argentum nitricum is also useful if there's a sense of trepidation, hurried actions, incessant speech, and diarrhea as a result of anxiety. Suppose a person, you call the patient for an appointment and say tomorrow you have an appointment, and the next day the person could say, doctor, I did not come because I got nervous and I got diarrhea due to nervousness, then definitely this is one of the remedies to think of. And there are a range of mouthwashes as well available, not over the counter, but something which you can encourage your patients to prepare for those who would prefer having an alternative form. So the most important of these is calendula and hypericum. So hypericum and calendula, the combination of which, and I'm talking about the tincture, okay? The tincture is the crude form. It will leave the mouth feeling comfortable and fresh after treatment. It is particularly indicated after surgery as calendula has excellent healing properties, okay? And conventionally, it is also used as a to apply over bruises, cuts, burns. So let's say a kid falls down and we normally dilute calendula tincture in water and apply to the wound. So it is an excellent use even post-dental procedures and even as a mouthwash because of its excellent healing properties. Calendula is your common marigold flower, okay? And hypericum, again, it has an affinity for the nerve, so it will bring about healing as well as cause the nerves in the mouth to relax a bit. Take one or two drops of the tincture in a glass. And by glass, I mean around 150 to 250 ml of warm water, and gargling can be done. There are also other gargles available from natural health shops, mostly in homeopathic pharmacies all across India. And there are plenty of them available on Amazon or 1MG for that matter, with combination of ingredients including tinctures of myrrh, propolis, and crameria. all of which are used in homeopathy as well as much as it is used in other systems of natural medicine. And essential oils of cloves, eucalyptus, and peppermint, which can be used along with these tinctures. And we also have peppermint and eucalyptus remedies in homeopathy. So there are a number of companies providing alternative toothpaste. You get heaps of them. Again, of all the homeopathic companies, you have SBL, Schwabe, Medicine, Vaccines. Again, if you search on Amazon or if you search on 1MG, you get all of these available, and a prescription might not be needed for this. So alternative toothpaste, if a patient prefers using an Ayurvedic toothpaste or something where you know that they have sensitive teeth, and homeopathy can also do really good for such cases, then there are these toothpastes which do not contain ingredients like fluoride, sweeteners, colorings, or sodium lauryl sulfate. Since a lot of people are becoming very conscious about moving to a sustainable lifestyle and may opt for options as this, I think it's the need of the hour to be equipped with knowledge from other systems of medicines and alternative ways of healing so that y'all can offer them to your clients. Herbal toothpaste is available nowadays over the counter for those who dislike the taste of salt. We have Cromeria, which is very beneficial for gums. Sanguinaria is another favorite botanic ingredient. And there are various other toothpastes which contain also aloe vera and propolis. So before I go ahead with the cases, I would like to speak about really some common remedies which I frequently use in my practice. They are arnica, hypericum, calendula, chamomilla, myrcol, and silicea. Now, you remember I told you I would discuss the case of my dad. So my dad had to undergo extraction of a tooth quite recently in the month of June, and he was quite apprehensive about going for the procedure given the fact that he is diabetic. So I went to a dentist friend of mine and I told her that I would be giving my medication before the treatment and post the treatment. So before he could start with the treatment, I gave him arnica, the remedy arnica montana, in the 30th potency to be dissolved in water, like say 20 pills of the medicine dissolved in water, and take it for 2 days before the procedure. The procedure went on smoothly with minimal bleeding, and there was a little bit of bone which came out as well as what my friend informed me about. And she told that, see, I'm writing Enzoflam, keep it with you. Your dad might be in a lot of pain. Once we came out of the dental clinic, we started back again on arnica dilution, and we came home at about 7 p.m. And at 9:30, I asked him, like, Dara, how are you feeling? And he's like, I'm absolutely having no pain. So I was like, yay, no taking Enzoflam now. You'll be fine with arnica at night before he could sleep, just because I know that there was some bone piece which came out as well. I actually gave him hypericum and symphytum in 30-30 potencies, knowing that that would cause healing and tissue formation as well. Hypericum for the nerves and symphytum. I forgot to add symphytum here, because that is only again when there is a little bit of bone piece coming out or things like that. Another common remedy I've used is calendula. Calendula again for post-dental procedures. I did make a mention of chamomilla, that how it is one remedy in my kit of remedies which I send to patients who are overseas and who are not in Goa. Myrcol is another remedy which I have used with great success for people who come up with acute toothache. If they don't have plantago, then Myrcol 30 really helps, especially when there is an increase in salivation. Silicea helps in the abscesses and the gums and in the mouth. And again, I've used this with great success. Another case I want to share with you over here is that of my grandmom, she's no more right now, but it was in the year 2011 that she had a dental procedure done. I believe it was an extraction, and she was already on heaps of medication by then. She was on medicines for kidney failure as well as diabetes and hypertension. So I think she just went in for the procedure without informing the dentist about what medication she was on, or I think her sugar was not checked or something like that. I wasn't staying at she wasn't at our place that time. She was back in Mumbai, and when she just called me and she said, "You know, I've been to the dentist and my bleeding has not stopped." And she was prescribed Bottroclaat by the dentist, but it was not really helping. So I was working in Mumbai at that point of time, and I went over to visit her at my aunt's place, and I just asked her, like, you know, she had changed three night dresses the previous night because the bleeding did not stop post the extraction, and Bottroclaat just wasn't helping. I think they did not get the dentist appointment the next day, so they were like, "Can you please come? Can you please come?" So based on my knowledge at that point of time, I just took with me Arnica's one of the remedies, and as well as Hamamelis, which I've not made a mention of here, but it's very good to stop bleeding post any procedures. So I started her on that. It reduced the time I was there in like 2 3 hours. It reduced a little bit, but she still had to keep changing that cotton, and again, Bottroclaat was not helping her. So I just sat with her and I asked her, "Grandma, like, what stress are you going through right now, or what are you feeling because of this?" And you know, she told me something very characteristic. It might be seem a little strange for y'all coming from the background of the allopathic background, but she told me something that, you know, I just feel somebody's coming to murder me. She was not delusional and all of that, and she was very fine, and she was just around 68 at that point of 65 or 68 at that point of time. She just felt, I just feel, you know, somebody's coming to murder me, and I'm getting scared to sleep. I'm not getting sleep because I'm seeing a lot of snake dreams at night. And based on this little bit of information, I told her to stop what she was taking, and I started with her on another remedy called as Lachesis, which is a snake poison, which the source is a snake poison. But it is potentized to work in an effective manner. So Lachesis in homeopathy is a remedy potentized to work in effective manner for a variety of illnesses. So I knew, okay, snake dreams, and I think I just about graduated then. It was around 2013, not 2011. It was 2013. And based on this information, I gave her Lachesis, and believe me, with one dose, just one dose, the bleeding stopped completely, which she had to change four night dresses the previous night, and it did not stop even with what I was giving her with Arnica and Hamamelis. Lachesis with just a single dose stopped the bleeding, and she was completely fine. So that is the power of homeopathy, my dear friends and colleagues who are attending today. If we know, we've just covered up heaps of specific remedies for various dental issues. But if we know a little bit about the patient, if we know a little bit of, you know, these little dreams and fears or things which come up, and maybe you could coordinate with homeopaths in your area who would help you to actually pursue this healing art, just in cases where people prefer using an alternative form of treatment. I'm really grateful to you all for listening to me for the past 45 minutes now. And thank you for giving me this opportunity. If there are any questions or any information, I think Dr. Aditi, yes, you can take over.
Thank you so much, doctor. It was an amazing session, and I'm glad that we have one alternative medication for our dental problems. Even I never knew about this, so I'm very glad, and this was really very informative. Thank you so much for this amazing
Most
session.
pleasure.
So before moving on to question answer session, ma'am, I would request for your permission so that I will introduce my organization to all the participants.
Sure, go ahead.
All right. So I'll be sharing my screen now. Okay. So this is our organization, dentistchannel.online, with the motto "Healthy Smiles, which leads to wealthy lives." I request all the participants to kindly save this number and send one WhatsApp message with your name to this number so that you get all the latest updates regarding our upcoming webinars, workshops, or whatever whatever we'll be planning in future. You'll be getting all the updates through this number. Now, quickly going through the webinars and workshops that we have, and for further details, you can always visit our website events.dentalchannel.online. So right after this session, we have at 9 o'clock in the night, we have session with Dr. Melvin Johnson. It's on blood derivatives and their application in facial aesthetics. Do not forget to attend this. And in August, we have this amazing workshop in implantology for beginners. Batch 1 we had last year, and batch 2 will be having this year in the month of August. On 7th and 8th of August and 14th and 15th of August. All the details you will get on our website events.dentalchannel.online, or you can reach out to me through this number. You can call or WhatsApp at any time on this number for any details that you want regarding any workshop or any webinar. If you haven't subscribed to our Prime membership, I request you to do it ASAP so that you get all the added benefits through our organization. You'll be getting certification for each and every webinar or workshop that you attend. You'll be getting discounts for all the workshops. A lot more things are there for students as well. So I request you to join our Prime membership. It will cost you just 499 rupees for an annual membership. Details you'll get on www.dentalchannel.online, and you can subscribe us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and YouTube. Now quickly going to the question and answer session. Alright. So we have quite a good number of questions, ma'am. So first question is from Dr. Biswas. He's asking, any drug interaction between homeopathic and allopathic medicines?
Definitely not, doctor. There is no interaction whatsoever. It can be safely. I always recommend patients that to continue with your allopathic medication, and you can take homeopathy safely along with any medication.
Right. So moving on to next question, this question again from Dr. Biswas, he's asking, any homeopathic drug that we can prescribe for root canal treatment?
Yes, one of the reasons one of the reasons is to actually determine why this person is getting caries very often, right? So once that, yeah, the root cause of it. So once that is taken care of, that can be, a remedy can be prescribed in an individualized manner. But again, for most of the dental procedures, arnica is the treatment or is the remedy of choice, which is good for at the start to prevent any pain, to prevent pain, and again to control bleeding and the feeling of soreness and bruised feeling.
Doctor, we have even I have one question. In case of emergency, some dental emergency, if we come across, can we prescribe any homeopathic medication for that?
Yes, definitely. What is the most common emergency that you'll come across?
The severe tooth pain.
Severe tooth pain, then plantago tincture, always keep it. Or you can safely advise your patients also to keep it. You can just have them, put it on a little bit of cotton and keep it in their mouth. Safest.
Okay, perfect.
It's the most safest.
So basically, if we have to practice this holistic dentistry, all right, so we have to have one homeopathic doctor in our panel so that whatever we are doing and, for everything,
yes,
because that person would be the best person to prescribe anything.
Exactly. There are a lot of books, because I could see Dr. Akhil has asked you some books for further reference.
Yes.
And definitely one of the clinical books would be, can I put it down in the chat box?
Yes, sure, ma'am. Or you can share with me so that I'll be forwarding all
done.
The details to all the
done. Done. I'll suggest two books which are very clinical oriented books. Again, it's always better, like Dr. Aditi said, to go back to your homeopathic friend or someone in the vicinity to coordinate or collaborate with, for that matter. But if for emergency, okay, like you all know that plantago is something I discussed, or arnica is something I discussed, but I think by night we will forget those remedies, right? So something which you can actually go back to, I will suggest a couple of books, okay?
Yeah, sure. Okay, so next question is from Dr. Sarthak. He's asking, any after extraction, how many days required to take homeopathy medicine? Is there any criteria?
For 3 days minimum. For 3 days minimum. If the person feels better in day one, then definitely not to be repeated again.
So, next question is, how can we calculate the dosage of homeopathic drugs and especially for pediatric patients?
So homeopathic drugs are not dependent on body weight, first thing. Okay, they are dependent on potencies, and the safest to start with is the 30th potency of a remedy. Even in pediatric cases, like I have kids, I mean, I've treated kids even 11 months old with fever or with, the most common complaint I get with kids is the teething issue. I'm sorry, I did not mention that in one of my slides, but teething is the most common issue, and we have lots of remedies for that where it calms down the child. Sina is one very good remedy which calms down the child. Sina and chamomilla. Chamomilla is what we learn. But these are the remedies which calm down the child to not be really cranky and not be in so much of pain. So again, to be given in 30th potency, if the complaint is very intense, we give it every half hour in a water dose or every 1 hour, depending on the intensity of the complaint, or it can be given 3 times a day for a particular set of days, 3 days being the best.
Perfect, ma'am. Okay, so next question we have from Dr. Pragya. First question that she is asking is, how can we start with homeopathy in daily practice? From where do we get all these medicines?
So, first of all, I would suggest, which I will get back to Dr. Aditi with a couple of books, which you all can read up for your knowledge. It is having a very clinical point of view, but definitely we want, it would be always better to go back to a person you trust who would have a wider knowledge of this to guide you how to take these remedies, okay? Otherwise, you all can always stock up on essential remedies, especially with this arnica and stuff, which is given for simple toothaches. You can get these by going to your local homeopathic pharmacy, or you can go to the website that is schwabeindia.com, which has all these essential remedies, which you can at least just bring and stock by to those of you who dispense. You all can at least distribute plantago tincture in small vials to be taken in and given to your patients when they have tooth pain. What dosage should be given? Again, it's not dependent on body weight. It is dependent on the intensity, and always it is to be, since it's the beginning of it, always to be given in lower potencies. It is to be taken 10 minutes either before or after meals. There is no hard and fast rule. In emergency conditions, people want to take the medication that time itself. So at least wait 5 to 10 minutes before eating or drink, or after eating or drinking anything. Yeah, there is no restriction whatsoever on food not to be taken with homeopathic medication. I don't belong to that school of thought. The right remedy will never be antidoted by coffee, tea, chocolate, or garlic or onion. So you can safely eat or have all of these. Just that 10 minutes before or after, not to have it. Yeah, I hope I've answered all of the
Yes,
questions.
absolutely. So basically, what I have understood is that in my general practice, I have to collaborate with you whenever I'm getting any case or before experimenting myself. Anyway,
Exactly.
I'll be reading out each and everything, but still, you would be a better person to prescribe homeopathic remedies to any dental problem. So
Yes.
I'll be referring all my patients towards you now.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this amazing session. So before
Thank
wrapping up, any takeaway note for the participants?
Well, the takeaway note is, since a lot of you all, it was a very novel concept, I would suggest read up. There are a lot of papers on PubMed and stuff which have all of this, what I've spoken about today, which will give you a fair idea about how to shift into a holistic lifestyle. And it is the need of the day, right? We are moving into a sustainable world very soon. We are making sustainable choices. So I think when we practice sustainability, it's good if we recommend it to our patients of how they can also go forward for a holistic lifestyle. So yes, I will get back with the name of the book. So Dr. Aditi, shall I type it here?
Yes, it would be fine, ma'am. You can write. I see our participants are too impatient. or anyway, all the participants can reach out to me for all the details, and I'll be telling you the name of the books. Although ma'am has written two books, and everyone can go through it and find it. I guess these are easily available.
Easily available, and there are resources online as well.
All right. So thank you so much, ma'am, for this amazing session. We are very grateful you took out time on a Sunday evening. It's very difficult for, you know, a person to take out time on a Sunday evening. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us.
Most welcome, and thank you so much for the opportunity.
Thank you so much. And thank you so much to all the participants for being such patient audience. And so with this, we will like to wrap up the seminar. Thank you so much. Thank you. Have a great evening. Thank you.